So hello everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to the session of PIB 24/7. Main hu Manish Mishra and guys, in this session I will bring to you five important questions from the PIB news which are very important for the ESI section of RBI Grade B exam. So let's begin with the session guys, but before we begin, if you are new here, do subscribe to our channel and press this bell icon, and also you can join this Telegram group for daily quizzes and updated information about the daily sessions, aur iska link aapko description mein mil jayega. So let's begin with the session guys with the very first question. Consider the following statements regarding the Academic Freedom Index. So there is new index, Academic Freedom Index, that has been published by the Global Public Policy Institute. Okay, this institute, Global Public Policy Institute, has published this report which is known as Academic Freedom Index. So let's talk about the index first. So this Academic Freedom Index guys has been published by this institute in collaboration with the Frederick Alexander University and VDEM Institute. Just remember the name of the institute. Iske bare mein aapko detail mein padhne ki zarurat nahi hai. There is no need to discuss about these institutes and universities in detail. All right. And this index compares the level of academic freedom across the nation. Hamare jitne bhi desh hai, unme academic freedom kitna hai, usko uske levels ko ye compare karne ka kaam karta hai. And remember that this index did not compare the level of academic freedom in USA. USA mein, USA ko is country ne count nahi kiya tha, so remember this, right? And these are the 8 components of the index, and you don't have to remember the name of all the 8 components. This is just for the basic understanding, but you have to remember that there are how many components? 8 components in the index, which are freedom to research and teach, freedom of academic exchange and dissemination, institutional autonomy, campus integrity, freedom of academic and cultural expression, then we have constitutional protection of academic freedom, then international legal commitment to academic freedom, then we have social and cultural rights, and finally existing of universities. And remember, aapko ye sare yaad rakhne ki koi zarurat nahi hai, no one will ask you in this exam, okay? And talking about the ranking, so guys, Uruguay and Portugal were at the rank number 1 with a score of 0.971, followed by Latvia and Germany. So number 1 pe do countries thi, kaun kaun si? Uruguay and Portugal, jinka score kitna tha 0.971, aur uske baad kaun hai? Latvia and Germany. And talking about India, so India has a score of how much? 0.352 India ka score hai, and various countries like Pakistan, Brazil, Somalia and Ukraine have scored better than India. So India mein jo academic freedom hai wo kafi kam hai, 0.352 score hai. और इसमें जो स्कोरिंग की गई थी दैट इज फ्रॉम 0 to 1, 0 से 1 की स्कोरिंग थी, 0 था मिनिमम एंड 1 इज द मैक्सिमम. सो 0.971 यूरोपीय एंड पोर्टुगल द मैक्सिमम स्कोर, वाइल इंडिया का जो स्कोर था दैट इज हाउ मच? 0.352, विच इज लो देन द वेरियस कंट्रीज लाइक पाकिस्तान, ब्राजील, सोमालिया, मलेशिया. राइट, सो दिस वॉज अबाउट दिस इंडेक्स गाइज. नाउ लेट्स कम बैक टू द क्वेश्चन. वी हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई द करेक्ट स्टेटमेंट्स रिगार्डिंग दिस इंडेक्स. So India has a score of 0.352. Yes, this is absolutely correct. There are 10 components in the index. So no guys, there are 8 components in the index, which means this statement is incorrect. The top performers are Uruguay and Portugal. Yes, this is absolutely correct, which means we have only 1 and 3 as correct statement. Therefore, option A will be the correct answer, only 1 and 3. Okay. So I hope guys this index is clear. And now let's move on to the question number 2. So recently, Pakke Tiger Reserve in Arunachal Pradesh has announced to provide insurance against health issues due to COVID-19 to its green soldiers. So the question is, with respect to the insurance, we have to identify the incorrect statement. So let's talk about this. So this insurance has been given to the green soldiers. And who are these green soldiers? So guys, the frontline workers who are working in this Tiger Reserve are known as the green soldiers. Okay, inko refer kiya gaya hai as the green soldiers, and to them insurance has been provided by this Tiger Reserve against the infections due to COVID-19. COVID-19 ki wajah se agar koi bhi health issue hota hai to uske liye insurance provide karaya jayega to the green soldiers of Pakke Tiger Reserve in Arunachal Pradesh. And total 57 frontline staff hai jinko green soldiers kehte hain, they have been provided the this insurance, and the premium will be paid by the Wildlife Trust of India, which is an NGO. Remember this, this is not a government organization, this is a non-government organization. This Wildlife Trust of India will provide premium for this insurance along with the foundation, jiska naam hai Search. Okay, and the insurance cover hai, that is of how much? Rupees 1 lakh. Lekin jo log retire hone wale hain soon, unke liye kitna hai? Rupees 50,000. So the insurance cover is of rupees 1 lakh each, but for those who are retiring soon, the insurance cover is how much? Rupees 50,000. Okay. So this is the news, and now let's come to the question. Insurance cover is of rupees 2 lakh. No, this is incorrect statement. The insurance cover is of how much? Rupees 1 lakh. While for those who are retiring soon, it is rupees how much? 50,000. All right. Then National Wildlife Institute of India will pay the insurance amount. No, this is also correct. The institute that is paying the insurance amount is what? The Wildlife Trust of India, which is an NGO. Which means both the statements are incorrect here, and we have to identify the incorrect ones. So therefore, option C will be the correct answer here. Okay. And guys, talking about Arunachal Pradesh, so there are two more tiger reserves in Arunachal Pradesh, which are Nam Dafa, or you can say Nam Daf Tiger Reserve. Then we have Kamlang Tiger Reserve, which was the 51st tiger reserve of our country. Arunachal Pradesh Chief Minister is Pema Khandu. Pema Khandu is the Chief Minister. B.D. Mishra is Governor. And capital, I hope aap sabko pata hoga, Itanagar is the capital. And recently KVIC has announced to set up a silk production center. Silk production center in Arunachal Pradesh. ये हमने डिस्कस भी किया था पीआईबी में. सिल्क प्रोडक्शन सेंटर केवीआईसी हैज अनाउंस टू सेट अप इन अरुणाचल प्रदेश, एंड देयर इज अ पर्सन व्हिच इज नोन, हु इज नोन एज केजांग डी थोंडोक. आई होप आपने इनका नाम सुना होगा, केजांग डी थोंडोक, हु हैज गॉट द दादा साहेब फाल्के अवार्ड. दादा साहेब फाल्के अवार्ड 2020 फॉर हिज डॉक्यूमेंट्री. इनके डॉक्यूमेंट्री के लिए इनको मिला है. एंड द नेम ऑफ द डॉक्यूमेंट्री इज व्हाट? ची लूपो. व्हाट इज द नेम? ची लूपो इज द डॉक्यूमेंट्री जिसके लिए केजांग डी थोंडो को दादा साहब फाल्के 2020 मिला. एंड ची लूपो डॉक्यूमेंट्री इज बेस्ड ऑन द हनी हंटिंग. ओके, इट इज बेस्ड ऑन हनी हंटिंग. एंड टॉकिंग अबाउट अरुणाचल प्रदेश मोर, सो गयाल इज देयर. गयाल, और यू कैन से गायल, इज देयर स्टेट एनिमल. ग्रेट हॉर्नबिल इज देयर स्टेट बर्ड. ग्रेट हॉर्नबिल इज देयर स्टेट बर्ड. एंड ऑल्सो देयर इज वन फेस्टिवल विच इज नोन एज पक्के पागा. पक्के पागा हॉर्नबिल फेस्टिवल, ठीक है, वो भी कहां पे होता है? अरुणाचल प्रदेश में. पक्के पागा हॉर्नबिल फेस्टिवल. एंड डोंट कंफ्यूज दिस फेस्टिवल विद द हॉर्नबिल फेस्टिवल ऑफ नागालैंड. ऑलराइट, दिस इज नॉट हॉर्नबिल, दिस इज पक्के पागा हॉर्नबिल फेस्टिवल, जो कि कहां का है? अरुणाचल प्रदेश का है. ऑलराइट, सो दीज वर सम बेसिक फैक्ट्स गाइस अबाउट अरुणाचल प्रदेश. एंड नाउ लेट्स कम टू द क्वेश्चन नंबर 3. सो विद विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग ई कॉमर्स प्लेटफॉर्म SBI योनो कृषि ऐप हैज पार्टनर्ड टू बूस्ट द एक्सेसिबिलिटी ऑफ एग्री प्रोडक्ट्स इन इंडिया. सो गाइज, दिस क्वेश्चन कैन बी आस्क्ड इन योर वन मार्कर. ओके, ये टू मार्कर के हिसाब से नहीं, और इसमें हमें कुछ ज्यादा डिस्कस भी नहीं करना, कुछ ज्यादा डिटेल में नहीं जाना. जस्ट रिमेंबर कि कौन से ई कॉमर्स प्लेटफॉर्म के साथ SBI योनो कृषि ऐप ने पार्टनर किया है, ताकि जो एग्री प्रोडक्ट्स है इंडिया में उनको सेल आउट किया जा सके, उनकी जो एक्सेसिबिलिटी है फार्मर्स के टूवर्ड्स उसको इंक्रीज किया जा सके. ओके, सो दिस पार्टनरशिप हैज बीन डन बिटवीन इफको बाजार एंड SBI योनो कृषि ऐप. एंड इफको बाजार इज बेसिकली एन ई कॉमर्स आर्म ऑफ इफको. ओके, इफको का ई कॉमर्स आम है इफको बाजार. ऑलराइट, एंड टॉकिंग अबाउट SBI, द करंट चेयरपर्सन इज मिस्टर दिनेश कुमार खरा. दिनेश कुमार खरा, ऑलराइट, एंड ही इज ऑल्सो, ही हैज ऑल्सो बीन अपॉइंटेड एज द डेप्यूटी चेयरपर्सन ऑफ इंडियन बैंक्स एसोसिएशन. ओके, इंडियन बैंक्स एसोसिएशन के ये डेप्यूटी चेयरपर्सन भी बनाए गए रिसेंटली. एंड हु हैज बीन अपॉइंटेड एज द चेयरपर्सन ऑफ इंडियन बैंक्स एसोसिएशन? इट्स मिस्टर राज किरण राय जी. Raj Kiran Rai ji, who is the MD and CEO of Union Bank of India. Alright. So here the correct answer is what guys? Option A, IFFCO Bazaar. Alright. And now let's move on to the question number 4, which is about the e-Sanjeevani. So with respect to the National Telemedicine Service platforms, e-Sanjeevani and e-Sanjeevani OPD, you have to identify the correct statement. So first of all, let us discuss why we are discussing it. Ye news mein kyun tha? So recently, e-Sanjeevani has completed 7 lakh consultations, and out of these 7 lakh consultations, more than 2 lakh consultations was from Tamil Nadu. So at the top, it is Tamil Nadu, while at the bottom, it is Bihar. And Bihar mein keval 4 consultations thi, jo ki telemedicines ke through li gayi thi. More than 2 lakh in Tamil Nadu and only 4 in Bihar. So you can see the variation. So, and let's talk about this e-Sanjeevani. So the telemedicine service platform, there are two service platform telemedicine se related, which are e-Sanjeevani and e-Sanjeevani OPD. And both of these platforms guys was developed by CDAC, which stands for Center for Development of Advanced Computing, which is located in Mohali. Okay. And its basic objective hai, that is clear from its name, it is a telemedicine service phone ke through jo hai, medicinal services provide karai jayegi to the patients. Okay. And talking about e-Sanjeevani first. So it is a doctor-to-doctor telemedicine service system. ये doctor-to-doctor telemedicine system है that is implemented under the Ayushman Bharat Health and Wellness Centers program. So I hope आप सबने सुना होगा that Ayushman Bharat के अंदर दो components है. One is health and wellness centers under which government is making 1,50,000 health and wellness centers across the country and another component is Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Yojana. Alright. So this e-Sanjeevani is a component under Ayushman Bharat Health and Wellness Center and under this government seeks to connect all the 1,50,000 HWCs by the by December 2022 December तक government सारे भी health and wellness centers को e-Sanjeevani से connect करने का government का program है and presently telemedicine is being provided through more than 3,000 HWCs in 10 cities and now talking about e-Sanjeevani OPD So it was launched during the COVID-19 pandemic to enable patient to doctor teleconsultation because doctors ke jo clinic the wo almost band pade the to agar koi kisi patient ko doctor ke paas jana tha to uske liye teleconsultation hi chal raha tha private doctors ke through bhi so government ne ye e-Sanjeevani OPD launch kiya taki jo private doctors ki high fees ki wajah se kuch log teleconsultation nahi le pa rahe the us problem ko khatam kiya ja sake okay And it is offered at no cost. कोई पैसा नहीं लगता इसमें. This e-health service has made it convenient for the people to avail the medicinal services. And it enables two-way interaction and even generates a prescription slip also. इसमें जब तक कि आपको prescription slip नहीं मिलती, तब तक आपका जो token है वो बना रहेगा. Basically इसमें एक token generate होता है. Okay, इसमें एक token generate होता है और उस token वो token जो है उसकी validity तब तक रहेगी जब तक कि आपका prescription generate नहीं होगा. और अगर मान लो बीच में इंटरनेट कनेक्शन चला जाता है तो भी आपके टोकन वैलिडेट रहेगा कब तक जब तक कि आपका प्रिस्क्रिप्शन जनरेट नहीं होता है ओके दिस टोकन इज वैलिडेटेड टिल योर प्रिस्क्रिप्शन हैज नॉट बीन जनरेटेड ओके सो दिस वाज अबाउट दिस न्यूज गाइस नाउ लेट्स कम बैक टू द क्वेश्चन सो यू हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई द करेक्ट स्टेटमेंट्स रिगार्डिंग e-Sanjeevani एंड e-Sanjeevani ओपीडी सो तमिलनाडु इज एट द टॉप पोजीशन इन अवेलिंग द फैसिलिटीज ऑफ नेशनल टेलीमेडिसिन सर्विसेज प्लेटफॉर्म यस दिस इज एब्सोल्युटली करेक्ट व्हाइल बिहार इज एट द बॉटम The platforms have been developed by CDAC. This is also correct. And e-Sanjeevani is a doctor-to-doctor telemedicine service system. Yes, this is also correct. While e-Sanjeevani OPD is a doctor-to-patient telemedicine system. So therefore, the correct answer should be what? All are correct. Option D, because we have to identify the correct statements. Okay. And now, guys, let's move on to the question number 5, which is the last question for today. Which is this question, guys, is based on the government schemes because there were less news today. So I thought to bring a question based on a scheme so let's talk about this question a scheme to provide digital literacy in rural areas was launched by the ministry of electronics and it in 2017 with an objective of making one person in a rural family digitally literate through csc e governance services india limited okay through csc e governance services india limited this will be done And under the scheme, training centers have the responsibility to provide training to the beneficiaries and you have to identify the scheme. The question is, you have to identify the scheme. So, there are various hints which are given under this in this paragraph. So, first of all, the basic objective is given to provide digital literacy in rural areas. And the broad objective is also given, making one person in a rural family digitally literate. All right. Then we have launch year, which is also given. Okay. Then we have ministry which is also given ministry of electronics and it okay and the implementing agency is also given csc e governance services india limited then we have one more hint which is given as under the scheme training centers have the responsibility to provide training to the beneficiary so can you identify the scheme guys and let me tell you one more hint about the scheme so if we talk about the eligibility of the scheme so अंडर एलिजिबिलिटी अगर कोई ऐसी फैमिली है जिसमें एक पर्सन भी डिजिटली लिटरेट है तो वो एलिजिबल नहीं होगा ओके सो ऑल द मेंबर शुड बी डिजिटली इलिटरेट ओके एंड ओनली वन पर्सन फ्रॉम पर फैमिली विल बी प्रोवाइडेड विद द डिजिटली लिटरेसी देन और जो एज ग्रुप है वो कितना होना चाहिए 14 to 60 ईयर्स ओके जिस पर्सन को डिजिटली लिटरेट किया जाएगा उसका एज ग्रुप कितना होना चाहिए 14 to 60 ओके सो कैन यू आइडेंटिफाई द स्कीम गाइस यस द स्कीम इज प्रधानमंत्री ग्रामीण डिजिटल साक्षरता अभियान ऑप्शन ए पीएमजी दिशा इज द करेक्ट आंसर हियर सो इस टाइप का क्वेश्चन गाइस आप एक्सपेक्ट कर सकते हो अपने एग्जाम में एंड जनरली आपको हिंट जो है वो गिवन होता है अगर आपने स्कीम को अच्छे से पढ़ा हुआ है देन आप you can easily identify the scheme. So option A, PMG Disha here is the correct answer. And that's it for the session. I hope the session is clear. And if you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching. Milte hain kal ke session mein. Goodbye, take care and God bless.